viewers, welcome to the lecture series on financial accounting. Today in this lecture, we shall cover some important entries relating to the journal entries. That is, all those entries which are very important while passing on the entry in books of accounts, we will learn them. We will learn all those entries which we are passing in the primary books of accounts called journal. These entries are the basic entries which we have to keep in mind while solving the question. We shall learn its implications, the rules used for making this entry and passing on this entry. The objective of this lecture is to understand all those journal entries which are being passed in the books of accounts so that the information which is required for the transaction is to be understood, and each transaction, whether it is related to person, property or asset, or income or expenditure, should be recorded properly and appropriately. Now, students, let us understand the very first entry which we need to pass when a business is commenced. Imagining that we have commenced the business and we have brought cash into the business. So, the first entry which we are required to pass for bringing cash into business is cash account is to be debited and capital account, which is the representative of proprietor's account, is to be credited. Here the rules used are cash is a real account, so debit what comes in, and proprietor's account or capital account is a personal account and he is the giver, so we have credited the giver. Narration which we are going to write is being cash brought into business. Now, this cash is, when it is deposited into the bank, we need to pass an entry. So, second transaction will be cash deposited into bank. So, a little guess about this entry is that there are two terms, cash and bank. So, there are two parties, one is bank and another is the cash. So, this transaction will flow as bank, we know, is the personal account because it's the representative of banking company. So, wherever the personal account is there, remember in your mind the accounting rule of debit and credit for the personal accounts. Debit the receiver. So, banking company is the receiver over here because our cash is going from our hands to the bank. So, we will debit the bank account, and cash is our real account. We have learned in the above entry also. So, here it will go out of the business. So, it will be credited. So, this entry will flow as bank account debit to cash account. Such entries are also called contra entry. We will learn in detail about the contra entry when we will prepare the cash books. Now, one very important fundamental which we are going to discuss is about goods. Goods are often called as inventory or stock in the business. When goods are related for the business purpose, they are called inventory, stock or goods. Wherever the transactions relating to goods are used, we will classify them in the appropriate heads. When we have purchased or bought goods, we will use the account as purchases. When we have sold the goods, or dispose of is the word which is used often, we will use the account as sales. Purchase and sales are the primary accounts which will represent the goods. When purchases are returned, if we have not liked the goods, it might not be as per our expectation or specification, or there will be quality change or the quantity is not as we required. So in that case, a purchase return entry would be there. So here the goods will represent as purchase return accounts. By purchase return, we mean that whatever we have purchased, either some portion of it or any quantity of it can be returned back to the supplier. So now we are going to use this account, purchase return, whenever there is return from our side to the supplier. Similarly for sales, there can be sales return. Our customer can send back us the goods so sold. So in that case, we have to pass on the entry of sales return. The characteristic of purchase account is that of debit. It's also a real account because goods is a real account. So all the subdivisions of these accounts are real account. So goods are coming in, so we have debited it. Purchase return will be reversal of it. It will always be credited. So when we have to find out net purchases, we will subtract purchase return from the purchases. But right now, we are concentrating ourselves on the journal entries. So this is the format by which the goods are going to flow into the organization, and these particular heads we need to keep in mind when we pass entries relating to the goods. Now we will learn its journal entries one by one, where we will use these all the terms which right now we have discussed. First one is being goods are purchased. Now these goods can be purchased either for cash or it can be on credit. When goods are purchased for cash, then the cash account will be affected, or we can make a check payment also. Wherever check payment is coming, we will use the word bank. And when purchases are made for credit, credit here means that at the very time of purchasing, we are not making the payment. The payments are made when the due date comes or after the expiry of the credit period so allowed to us by our suppliers. So the credit, instead of cash, we will use the supplier's name, or we will use the term creditors or accounts payable. These are the words which can be used when credit purchases are made. Creditors, suppliers, accounts payable, or it can be name specific. That means name of the person as Mr. X, Mr. Y, Mr. Z, from whom the purchases are being made. Now let's see its entry. Goods purchased on cash. So the journal entry will be purchase account to be debited to cash is to be credited. Narration will be being goods purchased so this way this entry will be passed. Now we shall learn how the credit entries in relation to the purchase shall be passed. The affected accounts will be creditors. So now the transaction will be, we purchase goods from Shyam. Now it's not mentioned over here that we have made the payments, so it is assumed that it is made on credit. So we'll write purchases account debit. To Shyam. But if slight variation is made in the given question and it says that purchased goods from Shyam on cash, so the name of this supplier will become irrelevant. And for us, cash will be important, so the credit will be of cash. Purchases account debit to cash will be there. Here, an argument cannot be made that supplier's name is being given. We have to find out the materiality of the transaction. The cash is being paid, so we need to write the cash. Wherever it's not given, that cash is being made. Just a simple narration is given that goods purchased, we can assume that they are made on cash, and when suppliers names are given, we have to assume that it's made on the credit. So the question will specify clearly whether it's credit purchase or cash purchase, and accordingly we have to make the general entry. If a wrong entry is passed, it will affect the cash position of the company and it's going to present the balance sheet in inappropriate manner. Now let's learn what are the entries which are related to the sales. Sales turnover is decided by the help of sales entry because sales will represent the total sales turnover. So these entries have to be kept in mind. Let us see how the sales entries are being passed. Goods are sold to Ram on cash. So the entry will be cash account debit to sales. Here goods are being sold to Ram, but he has given us cash. So what has come into the business is cash. Cash is a real account. So debit what comes in. Here cash is coming into the business, so cash account debit, and credit what goes out. Since our goods are going and we know that where goods are going and it's sales, we are using the term sales account. Sales has a feature that it's always shown on the credit, while purchases account will always be debited. If the sales are made on credit, sales on credit, the entry will be debtors account will be debited and to sales will be credited. Debtor is a personal account, so personal accounts rules are debit the receiver, credit the giver. Here the receiver are the debtors or the third party, so his account is debited. Since we don't know the name to whom this credit sales is made, so we have used a general term for all the debtors. It's called debtors. Debtors account debited to sales account. And if some person's name is specified, say Ram, the entry would be Ram account debit to sales. So in this manner, the entries relating to the sales are recorded in the books of accounts which we are going to prepare for our financial year. Viewers, there are certain items in which the goods are being used other than purchase sales or sales return and purchase return. That means goods can be used for personal purpose or they can be used in the form of goods stationery or for any other business purpose. So let's see the use, how it's being used and how the journal entries are being passed. If goods are used for personal purpose, proprietor is using it for his own use rather than business use. So in that case, an account is used which is called drawings. Drawings account will be debited and the credit will be of purchases. Instead of goods, we will write purchases, because the goods are going out of the business and drawings means, drawing will represent the amount of the goods which is being used by the proprietor for his personal use rather than the business use. Then these drawings will be subtracted from the capital account of the proprietor. One more thing which we need to keep in mind is that when proprietor takes the goods at home, he will not take it at selling price. The cost price of the goods shall be used in the amount column. Similarly, if goods are sold as free sample, distributed as free sample, so when we distribute our goods as free sample, it's the form of advertisements. So the expense account, that is advertisement account, will be debited and the purchases account will be credited. So these are the two important entries relating to the use of goods. Now we will discuss the entries relating to purchase return and sales return. First of all, we are taking purchase return. Purchase return has the feature which is quite opposite to the purchases account. We know that purchase account is always debited. Similarly, purchase return account will always be credited because its characteristics are opposite to that of purchase account. Just keep in mind this entry, purchases account debit to creditor. It's the basic entry which we have passed. Just imagine that we have purchased some goods worth 1000 rupees. Now out of it, if some of the goods are returned back to the supplier or creditor, we need to pass a reverse entry. Here, creditor will be debited because he is receiving the goods back to the purchase return account. And when we prepare the final accounts, this purchase return will be subtracted from the purchases. So the net figure of 1000 minus 100, that is 900, will be shown in the financial statements of the company. But these accounts will be prepared separate. Similarly, sales return entry. Sales return is just opposite of sales accounts. If sales on credit entry is passed as debtors debit to sales, sales return would be sales return debit to the debtor. This way we will pass the entries relating to purchase return and sales return. Now, goods can be used for personal use also, or they can be used for other purpose like selling them as free samples or distributing them as free samples. So let's learn certain entries which are used for using the goods. Now students, let us understand one more important feature which is called compound entry. So compound entries are used where the transactions are more than one and we are using single entry rather than too many entries. In order to pass the relevant entries together, we use compound entries. When compound entries are prepared, one account can be debited and several accounts can be credited. First, second, or in the second case, several accounts can be debited and one account can be credited. For one account, debit, second account, debit to credit account. Or in the third form, there can be several debit accounts and there can be several credit accounts. 1, 2, and 3 can be debits. Similarly, credits can be 1, 2, and 3, and so on. So this is the way the compound entries are being passed. So we will exemplify such entries with the help of an example. Such entries are generally related to discount. When a discount is availed or being given to the customer, then the compound entry is need to be passed. So we will discuss the entries relating to discounts in order to understand the compound entries. Discounts can be of two types: trade discounts and cash discounts. For trade discounts, there are no entries. The net amount or the net selling price is being used here. But for cash discount, entries are passed in the books of accounts. So we will see how the cash discount entries are recorded in the books of accounts. A debtor of R to whom we have sold the goods, he has to give us rupees 1000. Now we want him to pay the cash early, so we are giving him some discount, and it is known as cash discount. For example, cash is to be received rupees 1000 and discount is allowed at 10%. So the entry will be cash account is debited. Discount is allowed, so it's an expense to us or it's a charge on the profit, so we will also debit discount to debtor. From debtor we need to take 1000 rupees, but we are allowing him a discount of 10%. So when we allow the debtor discount of 10%, the real cash in hand which we are receiving is just 900 rupees and the discount is 100 rupees. So this way a compound entry is passed where several accounts are debited and one account is credited. Its narration will be being cash received. In full settlement, so this is the form of an entry which is having multiple debit accounts and one credit account. Now we will learn another entry where there can be multiple credits and single debit account. It's also an entry relating to discount. Now here we are getting the discount. We have purchased certain goods on credit and now we are required to make the payment of the same. But our supplier has given us certain discount. So that discount will be our income. In that case, we are required to pass the entry in this manner. We are paying the creditor. So we'll write the name of creditor. He is going to be paid. Then the cash is being paid to him and certain discount is received out of him. Our liability was to pay 1000 rupees, but he has asked us to give him only 900 rupees. So this is discount received account. It's also a form of a composite entry where one debit is there and multiple credits are there. Its narration will be being cash paid to supplier in full settlement. Now we are discussing the third type of compound entry where there are several debits and several credits. When a business is started, a proprietor may bring cash with him or there are certain liabilities associated with him. So a compound entry can be passed with the assets being debited, liabilities credited and the balancing figure as capital. Similarly, when opening entries are passed. Now what do we mean by opening entry? Opening entries are those entries which are carrying the previous year's balances into the books of accounts. In that case also, the assets are debited, liabilities are credited and the excess of assets over liabilities will be the figure of capital. Say for example, cash of rupees 2000 is debited, then debtors of rupees 4000 debited, in stock of rupees 6000 debited, land and building 2000 debited, and we have the liabilities of sundry creditors as 4000. So the balancing figure will be represented as capital account and it shall be the total of cash, debtors and stock is coming as 4000 plus 2000 and 6000 and 2000. It's coming as 14000 and we have subtracted 4000 out of it. So the capital account's balance is 10000. So this way the composite entries can be passed in the books of accounts. There are certain additional entries or they are called the adjustment entries which are to be passed at the end of the year. Sometimes what happens that the expenditure is being paid in advance. Expenditure is recorded in the books of accounts for the 12 months, that is for period beginning from the financial year and ending where the financial period is ending. So if we are paying the rents, we are going to record the rent for the 12 months, that is for the particular accounting period. If it's paid in advance, that is for say 15 months, so 3 months rent would be considered as the prepaid rent. So the account head which is affected will be prepaid expenses account debit to expenses account. Here the prepaid expense account is a personal account. Second one will be the outstanding accounts. We have to pay the expenses for entire period of 12 months. Taking the same example of rents, if we say that we have not paid the rents for entire 12 months which are relevant for our accounting period, and we have just paid the rent of 6 months. So remaining 6 months rent would be considered as outstanding rent in the books of the accounts and the transaction would be recorded as expenses account debit to outstanding expenses. Expenses is a nominal account, so it's debited, and outstanding expenses is a personal account and it is credited because they are asking us the remaining arrear of the rent at the year end and we are going to pay. Outstanding expenses would be debited and a reversal entry would be passed for it in the next year. Similarly, when the prepaid expenses are there, prepaid expense has a nature of that of debtor and it's a personal account, so we have debited it. So these are the two important entries which we need to keep in mind when we finalize the books of accounts. We have learned today so many entries which are so relevant for formulating our business transactions and to record these transactions at one place called the journal. So today we have learned how the entry is being made, what are the rules associated with these entries, the nominal account is to be recorded as per the nominal accounts rule, that is debit the expenses and in debit the expenses and loss, credit the income and gains, real accounts are recorded keeping into account the rule debit what comes in and credit what goes out, and personal accounts are recorded keeping in account the rule debit the receiver and credit the giver. And there are so many entries from the inception of the business where cash is brought into the business till the end of the financial year, that is outstanding entries and private entries, we have learned in detail. So we are concluding up today's lecture, and today we have learned so broad aspect of the journal entries. With this, we are ending up our lecture of today. Thank you.